There's always been a bit of a vacuum in terms of bikes on which you can cover long distances in India. You do have today Harley Davidson, which even offers an Indian-made 750, the Street. Below that, you've got the Royal Enfields. In terms of cruisers for the masses, it's only been Bajaj. They started with the Eliminator, that progressed in 2005 to the Avenger, which was also a 180cc. But then, in the last 10 years, they've gone from 180 to 200 to 220cc. And we're now looking at three new Avengers, two 220s, the 220 Cruise and the 220 Street, and an all-new 150cc Street.
So that's three variants of the new Avenger. In the new lineup, it's this chrome-covered Avenger 220 Cruise that's top of the line. Available with an optional large windshield at the front, the bike sports wire spoke wheels and a pillion backrest, giving it a classic cruiser look. The Avenger Street 220 doesn't have as much chrome and gets a matte black finish instead. And the wire spoke wheels make way for 12-spoke black alloy wheels. Ergonomically, the bike gets flatter handlebars. Both the 220s get a 219.9cc DTSI oil and air-cooled engine, carried over from the older Avenger. When it comes to the chassis, there are only subtle changes, such as altered engine mount points and a rangier wheelbase compared to the previous generation Avenger.
So out of Bajaj's three new Avenger cruisers, it's really the 150 which is a game changer, and here's why.
With this 150 Street, Bajaj hopes to create a new sub-segment, the urban cruiser. Aimed at the customer who wants the comfort of a cruiser, but with the smart performance and sensible running costs of a 150cc engine.
So what's new with the Avenger 150? Basically, the engine, which Bajaj has based loosely on the 150cc Pulsar platform, but you've got more torque at the bottom of the rev band, which is really where you need it on a cruiser. Although, don't expect power levels to be the same as a 220 Avenger, if you're used to that.
Powered by a 149cc DTSI air-cooled carburetor-fed engine, the 150 Street can generate 14.3 bhp at 9,000 rpm. With 1.2 kgm of torque available at 6,500 rpm. Torque kicks in as low as 3,500 rpm and remains constant all the way till 6,500 rpm, which makes getting a move on effortless. Light clutch action and a smooth 5-speed gearbox will take the effort out of riding in city traffic. All the three new Avengers are loaded with telescopic shock absorbers at the front and dual shock absorbers mounted on a box section swing arm. Ride comfort is distinctly improved as the rear suspension has been tweaked and the seats have also been reworked. This means the Avenger insulates the riders from poor roads very well.
So all in all, the 150 Street Avenger does give you styling of a cruiser in the 150cc segment, which hasn't been seen to now. It's priced well at 75,000 ex-showroom Delhi. You've got a reasonably powerful engine, the mileage of a 150, which you wouldn't get on any other cruiser. Reasonably good handling in the city. All in all, if you're in the market for a 150cc cruiser, it's got to be the Bajaj Avenger Street 150.